Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. This one is a big one. Every year I have done Stardom Awards for the end of the year, 2018, 2019, and now we are at the end of 2020. I would have had this done way before this, but someone had to go and create a really good feud at the end of the year that made me reconsider one of my awards. Now, if this is your first time watching one of my award videos, here is the rundown. It is all opinion-based, obviously, as with all award videos. There is no way to be objectively right. It's all subjective, I guess. I don't know if I'm using those words correctly. It's all my opinion. Feel free to disagree, you know? I disagree with a lot of people all the time. So the different kind of awards that I have are Rookie of the Year, Most Improved, Best Feud, Best Title Reign, and Match of the Year, followed with MVP. So each one of these, I'm not really going to give a brief summary of what they are. I have two other videos explaining this, and, you know, most of them are kind of self-explanatory, so let's just move right on to it. So this video isn't like 30, 40, 50 minutes long. Moving on to Best Outfit. Stardom has come a long way since the gears of Jungle Kiona and Kagetsu. If you don't remember Kagetsu's first gear in Stardom, I mean, look at this. But this year was kind of the hardest it's ever been to choose, because over the last year, everyone either became really good designers or they all have way bigger budgets to splurge on their gear, because everyone is killing it here. Like, everything looks really, really good. This year, it could realistically be given to any of the wrestlers on the roster, but I do believe that there is one wrestler, one, who changed their appearance that just killed everyone else in this category. And that person is the winner of the Best Outfit of 2020. So the Best Outfit of 2020 award goes to Konami for her Mortal Kombat appearance, changing from her typical style that she has worn since her debut in Stardom all the way until this video game character. She's modified it in such a way that is undeniably awesome. Unfortunately, I did not plan out my videos very well this year, and I made a top 10 best outfits video shortly before this one, and I think you all probably saw this one coming, since Konami was number one on that video as well. So with that out of the way, let's move on to the Rookie of the Year. The Rookie of the Year is always the hardest award to give out, and this year was the hardest of all. With all of one candidate, this was a hard choice that nearly made me quit the idea of the award show altogether. After a hard-fought battle, though, the winner of the Rookie of the Year award for 2020 is Lady C. After dominating all of the other rookies that debuted this year, she is the clear winner here. Lady C has taken the Joshi world by storm, becoming the tallest current Joshi wrestler, with a rocky start, missing a number of her shows because of poor condition. She has become more consistent lately, and she is becoming more of a regular at the shows, which is great to see. Plus, she is constantly posting videos on Twitter, making her the only rookie that started networking and getting fans right out of the gate. So she is more likely to probably advance quicker than some of the other rookies did. She's a great rookie, and I look forward to seeing her progress and possibly winning the Most Improved Award of 2021, as there really won't be too much competition for next year unless some new rookies come out as well. So congratulations, Lady C. Moving on to Most Improved. The Most Improved Award was pretty easy to choose in previous years. It was usually a rookie that just had a much more obvious improvement over the year than other rookies that graduated around the same time as her. Unfortunately for me, there were two really impressive improvements this year, and because I don't believe in ties when it comes to awards, I have to choose one of them. The problem is how do you qualify one improvement over another? What makes certain improvements more impressive than others? The runner-up is Saya Kamitani, and this was a difficult one to finally decide. It's honestly just a whim on who actually got the award over the other. I think the main reason I decided to go with the other option was I don't know how much of an improvement she really made. I mean, when you start off pretty much from day one doing a running shooting star press, is moving on to a Phoenix Splash really that much more of an improvement? You kind of see where I'm coming from here? So the winner of 2020's Most Improved Award is Saya Iida. This is well deserved, and I think a lot of people will agree with me on this. Saya Iida wants to be a certain kind of wrestler. Nothing flashy, just raw, pure, old school style. A simple style. But hard to master. Since there is no flashiness, it is harder to get over with the crowd. You know, it's easy for the crowd to like you when you're doing Phoenix Splashes off the top rope. It's harder to make the crowd like you when the most impressive move that you do is a brainbuster. I believe that the work Saya Iida has done over this last year to make her style more impressive and entertaining is more of an improvement than what Saya Kamitani has done over the last year. So that is why Saya Iida is 2020's Most Improved. The Best Feud Award, or Feud of the Year, was pretty much locked in until very recently, and then something happened. But because I am not going to be able to talk about any of this without spoiling the award winner, the 2020 Feud of the Year award goes to Cosmic Angels versus Stars. Now, up until this feud, the winner was Tam versus Julia during their whole white belt shebang. You know, their feud started off really, really amazing, and then it ended really, really amazing. So it was funny that they ended up not winning the award, because leave it to Tam to create another award-winning feud at the end of the year to knock her previous award-winning feud into second place. Tam is amazing. This feud really could not be touched by anything else debuted or finished this year. It is the only feud or storyline going on right now that has years of build. Now, don't get me wrong, I think it would be disingenuous to assume that any of these girls, or Rossi or Stardom, were building up to this over the last couple of years that Tam has been in Stardom. But just like most stories, not everything is thought out. You know, some things are thought out and the rest isn't. Just like those stories, I believe what they did was they just took what happened and built upon it to add a new chapter. And this chapter is phenomenal. I won't go into too much detail on this because I do plan on making an entire video specifically for Cosmic Angels versus Stars, because I believe that that is one of the best feuds and storylines that have come out of Stardom in the last couple of years, and I really, really think it deserves some kind of attention. So the winners of this year's awards are Tam Nakano, Unagi Sayaka, Mina Shirakawa, Mayu Iwatani, Starlight Kid, and Saya Iida. I struggled whether I should put Saya Iida in here or not, because she really didn't do too much in this feud, but she was a part of it, as Tam does seem like she wants Saya Iida on her side. So I added her. Moving on to the Best Title Reign Award. Now, this one was super easy to do every other year. And just like a lot of the awards already, this one was really tough, because this year it just seems like everyone was killing it. Years before, it was easy. You know, there was usually one title reign that was more dominant than the other. You know, Momo's white belt run, and then I believe Arisa's white belt run, you know, is just not that hard to choose. But this year, the red belt and the white belt both kind of had really good years, despite things with the whole corona. This year, though, I do have to give the 2020 Title Reign of the Year award to Julia and her Wonder of Stardom title run. While Mayu and her World of Stardom title run was really great and had amazing matches, I feel like Julia's matches had more of a story. I believe even though Mayu had, you know, amazing run with amazing matches just as much as Julia, I believe Julia's matches had more of a story behind each one than Mayu's. While some of Mayu's did, I feel like they were few and far between, whereas Julia's, pretty much every single defense she's had so far, had some kind of story or connection with her arriving in Stardom. I mean, she had her absolutely legendary feud with Tam, and them just killing it, you know, starting off her title reign really well. Then she moved on to, I believe, Konami, showing off her technical skills. And then Himeka, inter-faction warring, you know, that stuff is always good. And then with the last one, Shuri, it's just crazy. It has been really, really good. It's reminding me a lot of, like, Arisa's beginning of her white belt run, where pretty much every match had a purpose and every match had a story and connection with the two opponents. And I'm sure as the numbers go on and as she goes on, it's going to fall. But as of right now, this is amazing. Moving on to one of the biggest awards for any kind of promotion, it is Match of the Year. And with the December 20th show, I was worried that once again, like the Feud Award, that one of these matches would take the match that I had already decided and completely replace it. Fortunately for me, while it was close, Julia versus Shuri was very, very, very good. I don't think it beat out the one that I chose. And the winner of the 2020's Match of the Year Award is Julia versus Tam Nakano for the Wonder of Stardom title. Now, when I first made these awards, and after the second year of doing them, I kind of thought that the best feud award and then the best match award was always going to be the same person, the same people, because if you're put on the best match, to me, it has to be an amazing story and all of that. Unfortunately, Tam decided to kill it, and while the elimination match between Stars and Cosmic Angels was great, it definitely doesn't come up to this. And then even though Julia and Shuri was amazing, I don't think it beats this either, because this one had way more raw emotion, way more raw power. It was very hard-hitting, and they really made you feel something watching this. This match was an all-out war, and with many other title reigns so far, Tam has given the title holder their best first match to kind of start them off with an advantage. And fighting to understand the other's feelings in the ring is something that Tam utilizes really well, and no one does it better than her. And so, 2020's Match of the Year, Tam Nakano versus Julia for the Wonder of Stardom Championship. Last but not least, we are moving on to what could arguably be the most important award, in my opinion. It is the MVP, the Most Valuable Player Award. From what I've noticed, the MVP award is usually given to someone who is kind of on top, you know? Someone who puts on the best matches all year long, someone who is just in the starlight the entire time. And while that is a perfectly valid way of doing it, to me, the most valuable player is so much more than just being on top or being dominant all year. The winner of this award for me isn't always the person on top. I gave, in 2019... it to Hana because of her, the work that she did with TCS and kind of revamping Stardom. And then in 2018, I gave it to Kiketsu for her backstage stuff, not because she was the red belt holder, but her backstage stuff, being the trainer, helping people, you know, really helping these wrestlers progress. And so the 2020 MVP award this year goes to none other than Tam Nakano. With the coronavirus being a huge threat to the entertainment business, like wrestling, Tam Nakano has really stepped up her game this year, not only being a leading factor in many amazing storylines this year and big matches, she's also helping outside of the ring, being an announcer for things, being voiceover actress for them, commercials, videos, anything. She's done so much for Stardom outside of the ring this year that you she just couldn't have not been the MVP. She's essentially become Stardom's spokesperson this year. Like, that's how much she's done. For a company who is going through something like this, it's probably a huge help. Because instead of having to pay outside people to do some of this stuff, they have Tam. I don't know if they're actually saving money on this, but they could very well be. So, some people might have given it to Mayu, Iwatani, or Julia because of the years that they've had, and the amazing matches that they had, and how they've been on top. They've been the faces of the company, essentially. But I just don't think that they deserve it more. Because I feel like the most valuable player this year has been Tam Nakano. There you have it. My Stardom 2020 awards. I feel like this year has been the hardest to choose out of all of the years so far, as everyone has just really killed it. Not considering the whole shutdown for half a year thing, it's been a really good year. Many amazing matches, many amazing storylines, new additions to the roster. Outside of the ring stuff, it's been really great, and I look forward to another great year next year. And I really hope I have an even harder time making decisions for awards next year. But